In previous videos in this course, I explained why you might want to utilize multiple scenes in OBS Studio. There's a lot of cool stuff you can do with scenes. And a better, more advanced trick actually involves nesting scenes within each other, using a scene as a source within another scene. I'm a scene playing a scene disguised as another scene. It seems silly, but it can be super useful. Let's take a look. Any high-tier live production needs a variety of scenes to show and quick, precise switching between them. The Elgato Stream Deck gives you 15 keys with customizable LCD screens behind each one that can execute macros, application launchers, and do scene switching and source muting for OBS, and you can nest folders for more actions and unlimited power! Grab yours today via the link in the video description. I'm EposVox, here to make tech easier and more fun, and welcome back to my OBS Studio tutorial course. I have many, many more videos on the software linked in the playlist in the video description, so check that if you got any questions. Otherwise, let's jump in. There's probably no end of uses for nesting scenes within OBS Studio, but I have found a few which seem to be particularly useful. One use is to get around the annoying issue of sources being global and showing any changes you make to them in all scenes. So for example, an obvious one, if I wanted to make a layout with gameplay footage full screen and then overlay a face cam in the top right hand corner, I can set that up. Make the webcam view a little smaller and crop off some of the empty space on the sides and top so that it's just me in the frame. The problem is that when I go to make a full screen webcam view, it will apply the crop filter to this usage of the webcam as well. An easy workaround that I have found is just to make a webcam nest scene with the full screen webcam. Then I can add that scene as a source to my gameplay facecam scene instead of adding the webcam device directly. Apply the crop filter to that scene source and it doesn't affect the use of the webcam device itself. So then in my full screen webcam scene, I can just add the webcam with no filters and it'd be ready to go. Sweet! Another more advanced use of scene nesting is how I handle my stream alert overlays. Instead of adding individual browser sources, image files, and text reads to each scene to compose my layout, I just made a scene called Overlays that I can add to each scene that I want it on. Then, if I update the Overlays scene, any updates are passed to every scene it's nested in, saving me a lot of time. My bottom bars, showing top donation, recent follower, and so on, is also nested in their own scene, so I can just hide that all at once. Sometimes I just don't want the bottom part of the screen covered, you know? So the hierarchy works like this. My PNG for my bottom bars and the three text sources for the text that goes in the bars is in a bottom bars overlay scene. Then I have the main overlays scene, which has the bottom bars scene added to it, along with a browser source for my Twitch alerts, a now playing text source, a donation ticker text source, and a few green screened memes that I will call up at will. Then I have hotkeys assigned to individually show or hide these sources based on what I'm doing. And by doing all this in just one overlays scene, I can just add that scene to all of my main scenes and update them all at once. It sounds super complicated. Can you even count how many times I've said the word scene by now? But it is super handy.
It's over 9,000!
If you want to have an alternate layout where your normal webcam or gameplay view is next to live chat, or you have your normal gameplay view with your overlays next to your webcam or someone else's stream view, you can also use scene nesting to make this work. Like I said, the possibilities are endless if you're creative enough. I hope this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course has been helpful for you. If it was, Falcon punch that like button and get subscribed for more awesome tech videos. If you like game streaming, come give me a follow on Twitch and drop a message in chat. Until next time, I'm EposVox. Happy streaming.
Thanks for watching this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course. More videos like this and a full master class are linked in the playlist in the video description. Click to learn more. Also, consider joining us on Patreon to help keep tech education free. Go to patreon.com/eposvox to sign up.